नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी कॉमनली आस्क्ड पैटर्न ऑफ क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम टाइम स्पीड एंड डिस्टेंस एंड वी विल सी अ ब्रिलियंट शॉर्टकट टू सॉल्व दोज काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. नाउ व्हाट इज द पैटर्न ऑफ क्वेश्चंस? सो यू वुड बी सेड दैट अ पर्सन इज ट्राइंग टू रीच एट द सेम प्लेस इन टू डिफरेंट केसेस. सपोज दिस इज हिज ऑफिस. सो दिस पर्सन, so two different cases will be mentioned. So same person starting from same place reaching the same destination. So indirectly it is being conveyed to you that in both the cases distance is constant because same place. But exact timing of both cases will not be mentioned. It will simply be told to you that in one case he reached 20 minutes late, in other case he reached 8 minutes early. So these kind of data will be given to you, late, early. So this is not exact time, this is not exact or total time, this is just a indication whether he reached early or late. So how to solve these pattern of questions? Now please understand, when distance is constant, we know that distance is equal to speed into time. In these kind of questions, two cases are mentioned, case 1, case 2, or two different days are mentioned, today, tomorrow, yesterday, today. So two different cases will be given, distance will be kept constant. So you can say speed in case 1 multiplied by time taken in case 1 should be equal to speed in case 2 into time taken by case 2, because distance is constant. So if two cases are given, then obviously in one case speed is more and in other case speed is slow. So when you are trying to reach the same place, if you are fast you will take less time. If you are running slowly, then you will take more time. But one thing is sure, product of speed and time will be same for both the cases because distance is constant. So let us see what happens. So when you are running fast, you take less time. The product of speed and time must be equal to the second case. When you are running slow, you take more time. So the product of fast speed with less time should be equal to product of slow speed into more time. So from here you can see, let's call them speed 1, speed 2, let's call this time case 1, time case 2. So you can see from here that speed 1 by speed 2 is equal to t2 by t1. So from here you can say that t1 is to t2 is in the same ratio as s2 is to s1. So two different cases are given, two different speeds are given, but two different times are not given. So you can assume the two different timings to be in the ratio of S2 is to S1. That means reverse ratio of speeds. So speeds are always given in these kind of questions. So reverse ratio of speed. Case 1 time is T2. So below that you have written S2. So reverse ratio. So let us see how these kind of questions are solved. So please understand that in these kind of questions, time 1 and time 2 are never given. It is given in these terms, 20 minutes late, 8 minutes early. So these are not exact timing. So what you have to notice, that what is change or swing in time taken. So two different cases, you took two different times. So simply tell me, what was the change in time taken? So in one day you are 20 minutes late. Suppose you want to reach somewhere at 9 a.m. So in case 1, you are 20 minutes late. That means you reached at 9:20 a.m. Case 2, you reached 8 minutes early. That means you reached at 8:52 a.m. itself. So what is the change or swing in time? So you can see what is the difference of these two timings. So 20 minutes plus 8 minutes, so 28 minutes. So you have to understand all these things before I tell you the shortcut. Now let us see another case. In one case, this person is 24 minutes late. In other case, he is 5 minutes late. So let's see his expected time to reach is 9 a.m. So in case 1, he reaches at 9:24 a.m. In case 2, he reaches at 9:05 a.m. So what is the change in time taken? So 24 minus 5, because in both cases, late only. Earlier, one case late, other case was early. That's why I added, you can understand logically. So here both cases are late. So swing or change in time taken. 24 minus 9 is equal to, 24 minus 5 is equal to 19 minutes, you can see. Here, 16 minutes early, 12 minutes late. So what would be the change? 16 minutes early. So if expected time is 9 a.m., he reaches 16 minutes early. That means at 8:44 a.m. itself, 8:44 a.m. itself. In case 2, he is 12 minutes late. That means at 9:12 a.m. So what is the change in time taken? You can see 16 plus 12, 28 minutes. So you have to keep all these things in mind before I tell you the shortcut. Now let us see what is the shortcut. So let's take an example first. So two different cases will be given, two different speeds will be given, but time taken will not be given. So let us see. Tappu walks from school at 5 km per hour. So speed 1 is given and reaches 15 minutes early. This is not the time taken. After school is over, he walks from school to home at 3 km per hour. So second speed is given, S2 is given and reaches 9 minutes late. T1 and T2 are not given. This is not T1, this is not T1, this is not T2, because exact time is not given now. So what do I do? Take shortcut. T1 and T2 are not given. So what do? I assume their ratios. So their ratios, S1, write S1 here, reverse. So 5 and write S2 here, 3. So you can say that T1 is to T2 will be in the ratio 3:5. So you can assume that T1 is equal to 3T minutes and T2 is equal to 5T minutes. Now total time or exact time is not given. So now you have converted them into a ratio. Now things will become easy. So in one case you took this much time, in second case you took this much time. So what was change or swing in time taken? So if you talk in terms of t, so this is equal to 5t minus 3t. In one case you are taking 5t, in other case you are taking 3t. So 5t minus 3t is equal to 2t. This is the swing in time taken in terms of t. In terms of minute, data is provided to us. So here 15 minutes early, here 9 minutes late. So swing in time in terms of minute, 15 plus 9, because here it is early, here it is late. So 24 minutes. So what does this mean? It means that 2t must be equal to 24 minutes. So from here t must be equal to 12 minutes. So if t is equal to 12 minutes, 3t means what? 3 into 12, 36 minutes. 5t means what? 12 into 5, 60 minutes. So now picture is clear. In first case, you had taken 36 minutes. In second case, you have taken 60 minutes. Now answer whatever is being asked. Find distance between his home and school. So we have to find the distance he is traveling. So distance is equal to speed into time. स्पीड इज ऑलरेडी गिवन, नाउ यू हैव फाउंड आउट द टाइम एज वेल, नाउ यू कैन फाइंड द डिस्टेंस. सो 60 मिनट्स इज इक्वल टू 1 आवर. दिस इज फॉर केस टू. सो इन केस टू यू आर ट्रेवलिंग एट दिस स्पीड. सो सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज ऑफ केस टू, यू विल गेट द आंसर. सो स्पीड, आई एम चूजिंग केस टू टू फाइंड द डिस्टेंस, इज इक्वल टू 3 किलोमीटर्स पर आवर. टाइम टेकन इज इक्वल टू 1 आवर. सो डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड इज इक्वल टू 3 किलोमीटर. सो दिस इज द आंसर. नाउ लेट्स सॉल्व दिस. लेट्स ट्राई टू इंक्रीज आवर स्पीड. अ स्टूडेंट वॉक्स फ्रॉम हिज हाउस एट 5 किलोमीटर पर आवर. सो स्पीड 1 इज गिवन एंड रीचेज हिज स्कूल 10 मिनट्स लेट. इफ हिज स्पीड हैड बीन 6 किलोमीटर पर आवर, सो स्पीड 2 इज गिवन. सो इमीडिएटली वॉट डू आई डू? यू एज्यूम द टाइम टेकन, बिकॉज टाइम टेकन इज नॉट मैंशन, इन द रिवर्स रेशियो. राइट 5 हीयर, राइट 6 हीयर. सो 6 इज टू 5. सो यू कैन एज्यूम दैट टाइम टेकन इन दिस केस वॉज 6t एंड इन दिस केस इट वॉज 5t. सो चेंज इन टाइम, चेंज इन टाइम इन टर्म्स ऑफ टी, 60 माइनस 5t इज इक्वल टू वॉट? 60 माइनस 5t इज इक्वल टू टी इन टर्म्स ऑफ मिनट. फर्स्ट केस ही रीच्ड 10 मिनट्स लेट. इन सेकेंड केस ही रीच्ड 15 मिनट्स अर्ली. सो 10 प्लस 15, 25 मिनट्स. सो टी इज इक्वल टू, सी हियर 10 मिनट्स लेट, हियर 15 मिनट्स अर्ली. सो दैट्स वाई 10 प्लस 15, 25 मिनट्स. सो टी इज इक्वल टू 25 मिनट्स मीन्स वॉट? 6t इज इक्वल टू 150 मिनट्स, 150 मिनट्स विच इज इक्वल टू 2.5 आवर्स. एंड 5t इज इक्वल टू 125 मिनट्स. सो दैट इज इक्वल टू 2 आवर्स 5 मिनट्स. क्वेश्चन इज वॉट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन हिज स्कूल एंड हाउस. सो चूज एनी कन्वीनियंट वैल्यू. 2.5 आवर इज अ कन्वीनियंट वैल्यू. सो सब्स्टिट्यूट द स्पीड. स्पीड इन केस 1 इज 5 किलोमीटर. सो वी नो दैट डिस्टेंस इज इक्वल टू स्पीड 1 इंटू टाइम 1. सो स्पीड 1 5 किलोमीटर पर आवर, टाइम 1 2.5 किलोमीटर पर आवर. सो 5 इंटू 2.5, 12.5 किलोमीटर्स. सो दिस इज द फाइनल आंसर. Now let's see this one. Gogi walks from home to school at 2.5 km per hour. So speed 1 is given and he is 6 minutes late. Next day he increases his speed by 1 km per hour. So next day his speed would be 2.5 plus 1. That is 3.5 km per hour. So this is speed 2 and he reaches 6 minutes early. So immediately assume the ratio of time taken in reverse order. 2.5, so write 2.5 here. 3.5, write 3.5 here. This ratio, so this can also be written as 7 is to 5. So you can assume that t1 is equal to 7t, t2 is equal to 5t. So change in time taken, change 7t minus 5t is equal to what? 2t. In terms of minute, 6 minutes late, 6 minutes early. So 12 minutes is equal to 12 minutes. So from here you will get to understand that t is equal to 6 minutes. So if t is equal to 6 minutes, 7t is equal to 42 minutes and 5t is equal to 30 minutes. So 30 minutes is equal to half an hour, convenient value. So to find the distance, you choose or substitute values in case 2, because 30 minutes is equal to half hour, convenient. So distance is equal to speed 2 into time taken in case 2. Speed in case 2 3.5, time taken in case 2 half an hour, that means half. So 3.5 into half is 1.75 kilometers. This is the answer. What is the distance between Alankar's house and office if he reach office late by 20 minutes traveling at 10 km per hour? So speed 1 is given, 20 minutes late is what is happening in case 1. केस टू स्पीड इज 15 किलोमीटर्स पर आवर, सो दिस इज स्पीड टू एंड दिस इज व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन केस टू. सो इमीडिएटली एज्यूम T1 इज टू T2, रिवर्स, S1 इज 10, सो राइट 10 हियर, S2 इज 15, सो राइट 15 हियर. दिस रेशियो, दिस कैन बी सिंप्लीफाइड एज 3:2. सो एज्यूम 3t एंड 2t. सो चेंज इन टर्म्स ऑफ टी, इन टर्म्स ऑफ टी द चेंज इज टी इटसेल्फ, इन टर्म्स ऑफ मिनट, लेट बाय 20 मिनट्स एंड हियर अर्ली बाय 15 मिनट्स. सो 15 प्लस 20, 35 मिनट्स. नाउ सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस हियर, सो दिस इज 105 मिनट्स, दिस इज 70 मिनट्स. सो 70 मिनट्स इज इक्वल टू व्हाट, 60 मिनट्स प्लस 10 मिनट्स, सो 1 आवर प्लस 1/6 ऑफ एन आवर. कन्वीनियंट वैल्यू, सो यू कैन से 7/6 ऑफ एन आवर. व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन, फाइंड द डिस्टेंस. सो नाउ यू कैन फाइंड द डिस्टेंस, सो यू सब्स्टिट्यूट दैट डिस्टेंस इज इक्वल टू स्पीड 2 इनटू टाइम टेकन इन केस 2. व्हाट वाज स्पीड इन सेकंड केस, 15 किलोमीटर्स. सो 15 इनटू टाइम टेकन वाज 7/6, 7/6. सो 15 एंड 6 कैन बी कैंसिल्ड आउट, 2 एंड 5, सो 35/2, 17.5 किलोमीटर्स. So now let us see this one. If a train runs at 40 km per hour, so this is speed 1, it reaches its destination late by 11 minutes. But if it runs at 50 km per hour, this is speed 2, reaches late. Both the cases late, but this time a little less late. So what do I do? You assume time taken. In what ratio? Reverse ratio. 40, so write 40 here. 50 is for speed 2, so write 50 here. So ratio is 5:4. So you can assume time taken to be 5t and 4t. So change is equal to 5t minus 4t is equal to t. In terms of minute, remember both cases he has reached late. So 11 minus 5, both cases he has reached late. Suppose he wanted to reach at 9 a.m. So in one case he reached at 9:11 a.m. In other case he reached at 9:05. Fine. So both cases late. So what is swing in time? You can see 6 minutes. So t is equal to 6 minutes. So 5t, 30 minutes. 4t, 24 minutes. What is the question? Find the correct time for train to complete its journey. So, first day he took 30 minutes and we know that he was 11 minutes late. So, correct time must be equal to 30 minutes. This is the time he took and we know that he was late by 11 minutes. So, 30 minus 11 minutes is equal to 19 minutes. So he was expected to take only 19 minutes. He took 30 minutes. That's why he was late by 11 minutes. You could have solved this using this data as well. So 24 minutes. So second day he took only 24 minutes, but he was still 5 minutes late. So 24 minus 5, you will get the same answer, 19 minutes. So final answer, 19 minutes. Now this is a unique type of question, but the concept is same. So it is said that walking at 3/4 of his normal speed. So what does this information means? This information means that S1/S2 walking at 3/4 of its normal speed. So if his normal speed used to be 4, his changed speed is 3. So that is why 3/4 changed speed is 3. Normal speed is 4, so that is why 3/4 you can say. Fine. So as soon as you understand this, you will realize that T1 is to T2, सो दिस इज गिवन ऑलरेडी इन रिवर्स ऑर्डर, दिस इज गिवन इन रिवर्स ऑर्डर, सो दिस टाइम यू डोंट हैव टू चेंज और रिवर्स बिकॉज इट इज ऑलरेडी गिवन इन रिवर्स ऑर्डर. सो यू राइट हियर 3:4, सो 3t 4t. सो इन फर्स्ट केस ही इज 16 मिनट्स लेट. सो वॉट इज चेंज इन टाइम? चेंज इन टाइम. सो केस वन ही वॉज टेकिंग 3t, इन केस टू ही इज टेकिंग 4t. यू कैन से सी दैट इन केस टू ही इज टेकिंग मोर टाइम. 4t इज ग्रेटर देन 3t, दैट इज वाई इट इज सेड दैट दिस टाइम ही रीच्ड 16 मिनट्स लेट. सो यू कैन सी 4t इंस्टेड ऑफ 3t. सो चेंज इन टाइम इज इक्वल टू टी, दैट इज इक्वल टू 16 मिनट्स. सो यूजली ही वॉज टेकिंग 16 × 3, 48 मिनट्स, एंड टूडे ही टुक 16 × 4, 64 मिनट्स. क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन हिज होम. ओके, क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड द यूजुअल टाइम टेकन बाय हिम. सो यूजुअल टाइम टेकन बाय हिम इज 48 मिनट्स. नाउ लेट्स हैव अ लुक एट दिस क्वेश्चन, दिस इज रियली अ गुड क्वेश्चन. रॉबर्ट इज ट्रेवलिंग ऑन हिज साइकिल एंड हैज कैलक्यूलेटेड टू रीच पॉइंट ए एट 2 p.m. सो दिस पर्सन इज स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम अ पर्टिकुलर प्लेस, लेट्स कॉल दिस प्लेस ए. एट वॉट टाइम ही इज स्टार्टिंग इज नॉट गिवन टू अस. इट इज सिंपली सेड दैट रॉबर्ट हैज मेड हिज कैलकुलेशन दैट इफ ही वॉक्स और ट्रेवल्स एट अ सर्टन स्पीड ही विल रीच हिज डेस्टिनेशन, लेट्स कॉल द डेस्टिनेशन बी एट 2 p.m. सो विथ दिस इंफॉर्मेशन वी कैनॉट टेल द जर्नी टाइम, वी कैनॉट से दैट एट वॉट स्पीड ही वॉज ट्रेवलिंग और वॉट इज द टाइम ही टुक, वी कैनॉट से दिस. बट या स्पीड इज गिवन, सो S1 इज गिवन बिकॉज इन केस वन इट इज सेड दैट ही इज ट्रेवलिंग एट 10 km/h. ही विल रीच देयर एट 12 noon इफ ही ट्रेवल्स एट 15 km/h. सो केस वन ही वॉज ट्रेवलिंग एट 10 km/h. केस टू वेन ही वुड ट्रेवल एट 15 km/h, देन ही वुड रीच हिज डेस्टिनेशन एट 12 noon इट्सेल्फ. 12 noon इट्सेल्फ. सो ही इंक्रीजेज हिज स्पीड फ्रॉम 10 to 15. नाउ ही इज टेकिंग 2 hours less. सो टाइम टेकन इज नॉट गिवन, एग्जैक्ट टाइम टेकन इज नॉट गिवन, बट द स्पीड्स आर गिवन एंड वी ऑल्सो नो द चेंज इन टाइम. सो एवरीथिंग इज ऑलरेडी देयर. सो एज्यूम द टाइम टेकन इन द रिवर्स रेशियो 10:15, 3:2. सो यू एज्यूम दैट इन दिस केस ही टुक 3x hours एंड इन दिस केस ही टुक 2x hours. सो चेंज इन टाइम, चेंज इन टाइम टेकन इन टर्म्स ऑफ x, 3x - 2x इज इक्वल टू x आवर्स विच इज ऑलरेडी गिवन एज 2 hours बिकॉज अर्लियर ही वॉज रीचिंग एट 2 p.m. Now he is reaching 2 hours early. So x is equal to 2 hours. So if x is equal to 2 hours, 3x is equal to 6 hours. It means in this case he was taking 6 hours. In second case 2x, that means in second case he is requiring only 4 hours. So at what time was he starting? So you take 6 hours and reach at 2 p.m. that means you have started 6 hours earlier than 2 p.m. so you can say that starting time is equal to 8 a.m. in the morning. Subtract 6 hours from 2 p.m. you will get 8 a.m. now what is the question? At what speed must he travel to reach A at 1 p.m. so if he wants to reach there at 1 p.m. starting at 8 a.m. so case 3 total journey time इज इक्वल टू 5 आवर्स. नाउ यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट एट वॉट स्पीड मस्ट ही ट्रेवल इन केस 3. वी नो दैट डिस्टेंस इज कॉन्स्टेंट. सो इफ डिस्टेंस इज कॉन्स्टेंट, स्पीड इन केस 1 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई टाइम टेकन इन केस 1 शुड बी इक्वल टू स्पीड इन केस 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई टाइम टेकन इन केस 3. सो लेट सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू. स्पीड इन केस 1 10 किलोमीटर्स पर आवर, टाइम टेकन इन केस 1 6 आवर्स. दिस मस्ट बी इक्वल टू स्पीड इन केस 3, वी डोंट नो, वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट, इन टू टाइम टेकन इन केस 3 5. सो यूजिंग दिस एस 3 इज इक्वल टू 60/5, 10 × 6 = 60, 60/5 इज इक्वल टू 12. सो 12 kmph, 12 kmph इज द फाइनल आंसर. सो लेट सॉल्व दिस वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन. अ ट्रेन ट्रेवलिंग एट 7/11 ऑफ इट्स होल स्पीड. सो इन दीज काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस एस 1 एंड एस 2 आर ऑलरेडी गिवन बट इन रिवर्स ऑर्डर. सो 7/11, सो हिज यूजुअल स्पीड इज 11 एंड हिज चेंज्ड स्पीड इज 7. सो दैट्स व्हाई दे आर सेइंग 7/11 ऑफ इट्स स्पीड. सो टाइम टेकन इज टू टाइम 2. विदाउट इवन रिवर्सिंग यू कुड हैव टेकन बिकॉज दिस इज गिवन इन रिवर्स ऑर्डर इटसेल्फ. सो 7:11. अ ट्रेन ट्रेवलिंग एट 7/11 ऑफ इट्स ओन स्पीड रीचेज अ प्लेस इन 22 आवर्स. सो केस 2 टाइमिंग इज गिवन. सो इफ दिस इज 11x, दिस इज 7x, सो दिस इज ऑलरेडी गिवन दैट इन केस 2 ही टुक 22 आवर्स. क्वेश्चन इज हाउ मच टाइम कुड बी सेव्ड इफ द ट्रेन वुड हैव रन इट्स ओन स्पीड, दैट मीन्स यूजुअल टाइम टेकन. सो इफ 11x इज इक्वल टू 22 आवर्स, वॉट इज 7x इक्वल टू? सो 7x इज इक्वल टू 14 आवर्स. वॉट इज द क्वेश्चन? प्लीज बी केयरफुल. क्वेश्चन इज हाउ मच टाइम कुड बी सेव्ड. सो इन सेकेंड केस ही इज टेकिंग 22 आवर्स, बट इफ ही इज ट्रेवलिंग एट इट्स ओन स्पीड ही रिक्वायर्स ओनली 14 आवर्स. सो हाउ मच टाइम कुड बी सेव्ड? सो 22 - 14 इज इक्वल टू 8. सो 8 आवर्स कैन बी सेव्ड इफ ही स्टार्ट्स ट्रेवलिंग एट इट्स यूजुअल स्पीड. सो डियर स्टूडेंट, I would like to request to you that if you are preparing for any of these prestigious competitive exams, so please do visit our website once, because on our website you will find that all sorts of courses are available, all sorts of online courses, pen drive courses. So everything is provided by Vidya Guru, and Vidya Guru is the best preparatory platform that a student can expect. So you can visit our website, and if you click on any of these exams, so you will get to know the complete detail of what you would be getting once you subscribe these courses. And please do give us a visit once you have already decided that if you want to appear for these exams. So let's be serious. You can hand over all your preparation worries to Vidya Guru. We will take care. We will ensure that you achieve your dreams. So with this thought, I end this video, and I hope that if you have liked this video, you would have hit the like button, and I would also request you to subscribe to our channel so that in future whenever we upload these kind of videos, you get a notification and you do not miss any video.